people like legends, people like ghost stories. I just thought it was time to find out.
In the northeastern part of Lancaster City sits the sacred Lancaster Cemetery, which is home to hundreds of memorials, big and small. One memorial has always stood out from the rest. That is the tombstone of Augusta Harriet Bitner, who died at the young age of 21 in 1906. Her memorial features a white, life-size statue of her likeness. Countless myths and legends surrounding the statue have circulated over the years.
Well, she's called the walking statue, so people say they see her walking in Lancaster Cemetery. They've also said that her eyes spark green, that she weeps for the child that is not buried with her. So the story is that Augusta trips on her wedding gown. She fell, she broke her neck, and that's been the story for forever.
While this tale makes for an intriguing story, it's wholly based in fiction. Augusta Bitner was born in Lancaster on August 24th, 1884. She grew up on Marietta Ave and graduated from Lyndon Hall Seminary in Lititz in 1902. On May 3rd, 1905, she married a man named Stanley Hart Tevis, and together they moved to Philadelphia. In their first year of marriage, they had a daughter named Sylvia, and then suddenly, a week after their first anniversary, Augusta fell ill to typhoid.
She complained of feeling ill for a few days. They lived in Philadelphia at the time. The water system there was just being worked on, the sewers and everything. They hadn't got as far as where Augusta lived. She contacted typhoid, and she pretty much died a horrible death. Augusta gave birth, got married, and died within 13 months.
Augusta's loving parents spent a fortune on the iconic statue. Its grace and elegance still radiates today, over 100 years later.
The monument was special order from Leland and Company in New York. It's white Italian marble. There is ivy circling the one pillar on her tombstone. There is also written an inscription, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want." It was Augusta's favorite hymn.
A mysterious thing about the memorial is the cryptic phrase, "Could love have kept her?" Did Augusta's parents maybe believe Stanley didn't do enough to take care of Augusta? Another notable thing that possibly supports this is that her maiden name is displayed instead of her married one.
I'm not sure that her parents approved of Stanley. The baby came 7 months after they were married, so I assume they had higher expectations also for her. I just will say that Stanley wasn't a bad guy. She was a Bitner longer than she was a Tevis.
Perhaps some of these questions are lost to history. We can find historical records and resources to tell Augusta's true story, no problem. But to explain the supposed phenomena surrounding her statue and all the mysterious hearsay tales proves cumbersome. Maybe the realness of the statue has been tricking the eyes of locals all these years. Or perhaps there really is something wandering these lonely grounds.